are often equally misunderstood by Christians. That's next.
Welcome to 100 Huntley Street.
Yes. Welcome to November. November
is the first. Wow.
I know. I. Music in this hour. We have recording artist Christina Paul with us. And she will be not only singing, Ron, for us during the hour, but she'll be talking with Moira. And I think, Moira, you've got a little more detail.
Oh, boy. We've got surprises with my guest today. She celebrated the start of a new year yesterday. October 31st is Christina Paul's birthday. She can't wait to turn the page on each new day. Born in India to parents who are Christian recording artists, Christina began traveling with them throughout the country at a very young age. It's not surprising that she has become a singer, composer, and songwriter. Her debut album in English is a beautiful package. Speaking of turning the page, let me just do that. I was saying to Anne, if I were a singer, I'd like one of these. Isn't that just wonderful? Wait till you hear the clear message about God's power, love, and grace, and how he broke into a Hindu family 7 generations ago. It's all coming up very shortly. Ron and Anne.
All right, Moira, thank you for that.
Sounds good.
Also, you have a CD there by Christina Paul. And she's going to sing, first of all, and then we're going to get to know her a little bit as Moira will sit down on the couch with her and find out her story.
That's right. The CD is entitled Surrender, and her first song that she'll be singing for us today is entitled Lay It Down. So here is Christina Paul.
When you look at your situation, do you think it's impossible for you to overcome? When you call on the Lord with faith and knock on heaven's door, the Lord will deliver you. Keep on praying and believing Him. Whoa, lay it down, lay it down, lay it down. Oh yeah, lay it down, lay it down. The lame to walk and the deaf to hear. You can have a miraculous healing if you just believe. Oh, just remember, you can ask anything of Him. Oh yeah, nothing is impossible to the mighty God we serve. Lay it down, lay it down, lay it down. Oh yeah, lay it down, lay it down. At the feet of the Lord, lay it down. Lay it down, lay it down, oh yeah, lay it down, there is power when you pray, just believe that He will make a way for you, He's the mighty God and He will see you through. There is power when you pray.
You wouldn't guess, but that is a premier album in English for Christina Paul, who was born and raised in India. And today is a very special day because I'm sure it's her first full day of a brand new year. Christina, come right in here. It was Christina's birthday yesterday, October 31st. Welcome to Canada. Is this a first to our country?
Yes. I've been here before for a couple of concerts. Yeah, this is my first time in 100 Huntley Street.
Well, we are delighted to have you here. Tampa, Florida
is
home. And you began singing at the tender age of four?
Four, yes.
Christina, you knew that early that this is what God had for your life.
Yeah, my parents are a Christian recording artist, and they've been doing this for a number of years. So I was born and brought up in that surroundings, and you know, I always had the passion for the Lord.
And so. You write such a clean, clear message. No problem hearing what these songs are all about. I don't hear anything Indian coming through. You wanted this to be for our market.
Yes, yes. This is my first attempt for an English album, and I've released 6 Indian albums in India. So I'm a trained Indian classical artist, so.
You're also a computer programmer, which just blows me away. That is your full-time job.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
That's left hemisphere and right, excelling. That's a little unusual.
Yeah, I just wanted to support my own ministry, so.
Mm-hmm. This is beautiful. I love this. I mean, I didn't even know we had an actual CD, but I guess this would be difficult to cart around at all times, but beautifully presented. Yeah. Now, I'll tell you what is beautiful is the story of how Jesus Christ made himself real in your family 7 generations ago.
Yes.
What happened?
My great-great-grandfather, he was a Hindu, and he had 15 children and 15 kids. In those days, I mean, in India, it's so common to have that many kids. He had 15 kids, and there was a serious illness, cholera. Ooh. Hit all of the kids, and 13 of them died.
13 of the
13,
15
yes.
died of cholera.
Yes. And at that time, he was working with a British missionary, and he used to talk to him about Jesus, how, you know, Jesus is the real God, and you accept him as your personal savior that's going to change your life for eternity. And my grandfather, you know, never paid any attention to him, till he lost all his 13 kids, and he was vulnerable at that point. And he told my great-great-grandfather that if the God that you're talking about is going to save my last 2 kids, I will accept him as my personal savior. Mm-hmm. God heal the other 2 kids.
They had cholera.
Absolutely, yeah. So that was the turning point in his life, and praise God.
And look
that's why I'm a Christian now.
Filtered down all these generations.
Yes.
I was thrilled to learn that you went off to university and your passion increased.
Yes.
For getting this message out, for reaching people who are empty and lonely and searching. But it was a Christian university.
Yes, it was a Christian university. I was involved in a lot of Christian activities. I was in a group of a prayer cell. You know, we meet every day after dinner and have a Bible study, and I was the choir secretary there, and you know, it was all spiritual. And when people sang secular songs, I sang for the glory of God. So, just trying to shine a little light there. Yeah.
All the right stuff. Now, we just had a wonderful story on Messianic Jews in Montreal. And you can see how important it is to them to hold on to the traditions of their culture and their faith.
Yep.
And similarly, to my surprise, your Christian parents have held to a tradition that isn't unusual in India today, arranged marriages.
Yes.
How scary is that?
I never thought it was scary.
No?
Because my parents, my mom taught me how to pray for my life partner when I was 13 years old. So I started praying for my spouse, since that age. And I basically asked God for a sign. I should know that that's the person when I'm going to meet him. That's the person that he has for me. So I fasted and prayed, you know, every Sunday since age 13. And
for
I
your spouse? Asked,
yes, for my spouse.
But and you didn't pick him.
I didn't pick him. But that's the whole deal about arranged marriage.
God.
I trust God. I put all the faith in him. Of course, you know, whatever my parents are bringing the proposals to me, I had the right to say yes or no to a proposal. But I need to know that that's the God's will. That's the man that he has for me in my life. So I asked God for a sign. I wanted 100% peace. Mm. You know how in Philippians chapter 4, verses 6 to 7, it says, the peace that passeth all understanding. I can't explain it. Mm-hmm. It's the
guards
peace that
your
I
heart
just,
and your mind.
Exactly.
You're good in both places.
Absolutely. So I just knew it. So when I met him, I just knew it.
Okay.
And we spoke for 30 minutes.
Come on, Paul. Come on here. Let's see how it turned out. Welcome, Paul.
Thanks, Rhonda. Thanks for having me.
The first thing people are going to notice is that your last name is Paul. You're not Paul.
I'm Paul Jessing.
Christina had to make a choice when you were recording. Mm-hmm. You wanted your husband's name.
Yes, I wanted my husband's name. They gave me an option. I could either be Christina Priya, which is my Indian middle name, but I wanted my husband's name to be my last name.
Now, Paul, how is this from your side of things? Were you positive about someone arranging your future?
You know, we still have a choice. It's not that you have to marry the person that your parents have asked you to marry. But I've been praying, and you know, God says the steps of a righteous man are ordered by God.
Yes.
And I firmly believe in that, and all things work together for good to those who love God. So I prayed about it, and when I saw her, I had peace in my mind.
So I can appreciate that, right. That you would look at Christina and have instant peace. We know it's not just because she's beautiful.
Oh yeah, that helps too.
But had you seen her at all? Did you know her from your days in India?
No, they told me her family's name, and their family is a family that sings gospel music in India. They're famous in the state where I'm from.
What state is that?
It's Tamil Nadu. So I knew right away that she comes from a good spiritual heritage. And so that was a big plus point for me right away. So I knew that I'm getting a good girl, and she's beautiful too, so it worked out good.
Very godly motives, both of you. You're praying, you're looking for someone who has the right spiritual foundation. The matchmaker wasn't your mom and dad or your parents.
No. It was a family who were friends with both our families. So they basically told about Paul's family to us, and likewise the other way around. And then we exchanged photographs, and then he flew over. He was working in Nashville, Tennessee that time, and he flew to India to see me. And we spoke for 30 minutes to an hour, and then we got engaged. And 2 months later, we got married.
Wow. Almost immediately, we're thrown on God for the life of your daughter.
Absolutely, yeah.
What happened? Yeah.
When my daughter was 6 months old, she was diagnosed with a blood disorder. And she just had a high fever, and we rushed her to the emergency because it was off hours. So there they did a blood test on her and found out, to our surprise, that she had zero cells towards bacterial infections, to fight bacterial infections. So if she gets a small bacterial infection, she could die from it. You know, ever since then, it's been a very hard, rough journey for us. I mean, spiritually, emotionally. I mean, spiritually, we were clinging to God like, you know, that we have nobody, because that's the truth. We have nobody but God only can help us out. And when, to make the long story short, when the doctors lost hope, they said one last time that they're going to try the bone marrow transplant. If that is not going to work, then they didn't know what they were going to do with her. So
she was 6 months old when this emerged.
Yes. And, you know, God, I was clinging to God. I was wrestling with him. And because in the Bible it says, by his stripes we are healed. When God died for us in Calvary, it's a given. If you believe, you're healed. So I clinged on to that promise and I kept wrestling with God. God, you have to heal her. I know that you're a healer and I believe in you. For some reason, you know, for some people, you know how it is, when you pray, miraculously you get a healing. But it wasn't the case with Joanne. It took God, for some reason, he took us for the whole year. And when she was a year and a half, that's when she got healed. But he did heal her.
You did a lot of fasting and praying.
Absolutely. I mean, you bet. The scripture says in James chapter 5, verses 15 and 16, the prayer offered in faith will make the sick person well. God will raise him up.
We know that doesn't always happen.
Yeah.
In the will of God.
That is true. I mean, and also it says, it moves on to say, the prayer offered by a righteous man is powerful and effective. So when you walk in the righteousness of God, and when you ask something and believe firmly that he's going to give you according to his will, he will grant you that.
Now, Christina, I'm sure you thought this because I had been in this place with an undiagnosed illness and a child at risk. And the question is, what if he doesn't? Who is God to me if it is not his will? Mm-hmm. If he's taking this child?
Right.
Did you think those thoughts?
Yes, absolutely. I'm a human, and the same emotions ran through my mind. But there is a verse in the Bible, Deuteronomy 29, chapter, verse 29, the secrets are with the Lord. The
God
secret is with the Lord.
Yeah.
Yes. So we are nobody to question him. Mm. So, well, he gave my child back. Praise God. I thank
Let's
God
see her.
For that.
Joanne, come on up here and sit between mom and dad.
Oh, come on, baby.
What a treasure.
She's a living
How old are you today, Joanne?
Six.
6 years old. What grade are you in?
First grade.
And is it fun living in Florida? Would you like to go to India, or have you been there already? You ever gone to India?
I never been in India.
You have been there. Probably she doesn't
she
remember
was very small.
When she was, as soon as she got healed, I went to India because I missed my brother's wedding because of her illness. I couldn't go anywhere. So,
well, need to go again. Make some more memories. This crisis pushed to the surface some other important issues that we see. By the way, the song Lay It Down was written during this crisis.
Yeah. I just wanted
Trust
to share
God.
It with the people out there. We should never forget what a powerful God we have. And when we pray, we are talking to the powerful person in the universe. And God is there to look out for us. So,
I started to say that this pressure cooker really opened your heart to God.
Yes.
And there were some things you needed to deal with that I think have a lot to do with the title of your album.
Yeah.
What was God after?
Okay. In my album, if you see all the songs, everything is coming under the theme, surrender, lay it down, let it go. Because I've learned in my life all these years that I cannot do anything on my own. I have to rely on God for every single thing. He's my every breath, my life. So that's surrender is just surrender song, the title cut, is my expression of my heart. That's how I feel. Mm. I just can't imagine a day without him. And it's, just up to him.
Christina, we're going to get to hear right now the title cut from your new first. You know, I happened to see Charles Stanley on Sunday, and he reminded us that God never says give up. To give up is defeat, isn't it? But he does say, surrender, and that's where the victory is. Thank you for reminding us with your title.
And Christina Paul is singing that wonderful song that sort of emphasizes that. It's coming to that place of surrender. Here she is.
I will surrender my life to you, Lord. You are the one that I live for. You are my life and my every breath, the maker of me. I am not my own. Everything I am, everything I have, everything I've been through, Lord, I offer to you my life, lifting up my praise. all of my plans, all of my dreams that are yet unseen. Lord, I offer to you my heart, I give you all the praise. Surrender, I surrender. How can I thank you enough, oh Lord, for all that you've done in my life? What can I give that you have not given me? Give you my all, I give you everything. Everything I am, everything I have, everything I've been through, Lord, I offer to you my life, lifting up my praise. All of my plans, all of my dreams that are yet unseen, Lord, I offer to you my heart, I give you all the praise. Surrender, I surrender. You gave me your life unselfishly, just to prove your love for me. There's nothing else I can give to you but to surrender. Yeah, I surrender. I surrender to you, everything I have, everything I've been through. Lord, I offer to you my life, lifting up my praise. All of my plans, all of my dreams that are yet unseen, Lord, I offer to you my heart, I give you all the praise. You my life, I give you all the praise. Everything I hope to be, I owe it all, oh, 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 to thee. I surrender, surrender, yeah, I surrender.
Thank you, Christina Paul, reminding us of the importance
and to bring restoration and work through us.
You know, many would see the term surrender and see it as a losing term. Isn't that what, in a battle, if you surrender, you kind of lose? No, actually, it's the opposite when you're dealing with God, because Jesus said, whoever will lose his life for my sake actually will find it, will save it. And so that's our encouragement to you. And thank you for being with us in this hour.
And make sure you tune in tomorrow for Full Circle.
All right,
God bless
bye-bye.
You. Bye-bye.